course of microwave engineering. In today's class, we are going to discuss about the description of microwave bench. This particular kind of microwave bench, we generally see in the college microwave laboratories and in several other places, etc. We can also have a chance of seeing these microwave kind of benches in a small kind of industries as well, which are related to microwaves. So let's see actually what is this microwave bench, what is the overall structure of a microwave bench, how it looks, and let us see and also get into the block diagram of a microwave bench. This microwave bench setup is also called as microwave test setup. Okay, so the microwave test bench incorporates microwave devices as well as instruments. So the test bench or the microwave bench allows all types of microwave measurements such as frequency, power, attenuation, and VSWR, which we generally call as voltage standing wave ratio, of a wave inside the waveguide of a microwave test setup or a bench setup. So using this microwave bench or the microwave test setup, we can measure various parameters like frequency, power, attenuation, and voltage standing wave ratio of the wave which is traveling inside the waveguide of a microwave bench setup. Okay, so this is how a microwave bench setup looks. So if you start from the left side, we will have an klystron power supply and a klystron amplifier or an oscillator. We'll be having an isolator followed by variable attenuator, followed by frequency meter, then comes the slotted line, then comes the match termination or the terminators, and this slotted line or the knobs over here are connected to a probe through which we can take the readings of a particular signal flowing in the waveguide. Okay, now if we see the block diagram of a microwave bench setup, the diagram which we have seen in the previous one, it's this one is a block diagram representation of that particular figure. So if you see here, so the first one is our klystron or the klystron power supply that will be connected to our klystron or the klystron mount tube, and this klystron mount tube or the klystron amplifier or the oscillator is connected to an isolator, and this isolator is connected to a variable attenuator, and this variable attenuator connected to a frequency meter, then this frequency meter goes and connected to a slotted line section, and this slotted line section will be connected to a load. So this load can be of various types. Let's see what are those loads. And this slotted line section is also connected to a VSWR meter, and it can also be connected to a CRO to take the readings. So as I said, VSWR is a voltage standing wave ratio. So we can take the measurements or the take the readings of a particular signal which is passing from this klystron mount tube towards all this, and we can also measure or take the readings using a VSWR meter or a CRO by connecting through this particular slotted line section or through this particular terminal. Okay, now let's see one by one how and each blocks are used for this microwave bench setup. So the first blocks what we seen here are the klystron power supply and the klystron mount tube, and the klystron power supply can provide the voltage up to 240 volts to 420 volts, and this power supply is mainly used for providing the supply for the klystron mount tube. So this klystron mount tube is also called as a microwave source, which can also be called as a klystron amplifier or a klystron oscillator. So, and the other possible microwave sources are gun diode and the magnetron, etc. So apart from the klystron devices, we can also use gun diode and the magnetron as a microwave sources. And coming to the next block, after the klystron power supply and the klystron mount tube, we have an isolator. So whatever the signal or the microwave signal which is generated by the klystron mount tube is sent to an isolator. So we have already seen in the previous unit the working of an isolator. This isolator allows the flow of wave only in a one direction or a single direction. So as we all know, the isolator is used for the transmission of signal only in a single direction. We can also see the diagram over here. This isolator has got a three-port network where one port is terminated, and we can clearly observe the signal is flowing through a single direction from port 1 to the port 2, and there is no reflection or the reback of the signal from the port 2 towards the port 1. So if at all we are using an isolator in the microwave bench, this isolator takes the signal from the klystron mount tube and sends the signals only in a single direction, which avoids the reflections of the signal. Okay, that is what the main function of an isolator. Here comes the next block. So next block is the variable attenuator. So the main purpose of a variable attenuator is to stabilize the energy of the wave passing in the waveguide. So whenever a signal, microwave signal, which is passing through the microwave bench setup, sometimes this signal might be having high power fluctuations or a low power fluctuations. So this variable attenuator or a fixed attenuator or basically an attenuator is used for attenuation of the signal. So attenuation of the signal is nothing but to balance the power present in the microwave signal or to stabilize the energy of the wave passing through the waveguide. So in order to avoid the fluctuations of a microwave signal present in the microwave bench setup, we will be using attenuators. So if we are going to use a variable attenuator in the bench setup, according to the user preference, we can alter the power present in the microwave signal. Okay, this is the main use of a variable attenuator. Next comes a frequency meter. So it measures the frequency of the wave or a signal present in the waveguide in gigahertz. So whatever the frequency or whatever the microwave signals generated by this klystron mount is passed through an isolator in a single direction, then goes towards a variable attenuator where the signal is getting attenuated and it reaches the frequency meter. So this is a frequency meter which we generally come across in a microwave bench. So using this frequency meter, we can also measure the frequency of the signal in gigahertz. So whatever the signal passing in this microwave bench setup or the test setup, okay, we can measure at what frequency the signal is flowing. So we can clearly extract the frequency, or we can clearly take the readings of a frequency of that particular signal which is moving in that particular microwave bench setup waveguide. So this is how a frequency meter is used for. So next comes the slotted line section. So this slotted line section takes the signal from the waveguide. If you see here, this whole part is a slotted line section where this is looks like a scale reading or a vernier calipers, which is connected to a waveguide. You can see a waveguide at the bottom, and this knob is used for rotating the slotted line to and fro. Okay, so this slotted line is nothing but it's a scale reading, reading of a scale, or the scale reading which is attached to a waveguide, and a probe or a coupling probe or any kind of wire kind of mechanism which has a probe connection can be attached to this particular slotted line, and the readings of the particular wave present in this waveguide can be measured using our VSWR meter or the CRO. So a slotted line is a waveguide with a slot where a probe can be connected. You can see a circular ring over here, right? So here we can connect a probe, and that probe can be connected to a VSWR meter or a CRO, through which we can read the or we can measure the readings of a particular signal or a microwave signal which is flowing through this bench setup or a waveguide. Okay, so by moving this slotted line left side as well as right side, or by moving this slotted line to and fro, we can also alter the modulation of a waveform. Okay, all these things can be practically seen in the laboratory. Okay, so if at all you move this particular knob of a slotted line, you can alter the modulation of a particular microwave signal which is flowing in the waveguide. That can be observed on the CRO using a coupling probe or a CRO probes connected to this particular slotted line. That is the main function of a slotted line section. Okay, so we can measure the readings from a slotted line section. Okay, we can alter the modulation of a microwave signal present in the waveguide using a slotted line section. That is the main function of a slotted line section. Next, coming to the VSWR meter and CRO. So, as I said earlier, VSWR meter or the CRO, these both we can call it as an output devices, which are mainly used to measure the waveform or the signal coming from the waveguide. Okay, we can see how much amplitude it has got. We can see how much time period it has got in the CRO thing. And we can also measure the voltage standing wave ratio in the using this VSWR meter, which can be practically seen in the laboratories. So mainly a VSWR meter as well as CRO are used to measure the signal present in the waveguide which is flowing throughout the bend setup. Okay, and next comes the last one is the load. Okay, this load can be our detector mount or a matched termination. So you can see here at the end of this particular whole microwave bench setup, if we use a matched termination, that means we are closing the circuit till here. Okay, just we are keeping an obstacle such that the signal won't be passing much more further. Okay, otherwise let us say we are using a detector mount. So this is a detector mount. This detector mount is connected at a slot after the slotted line section, let us say. Okay, if we want to measure the readings after the slotted line section, okay, this detector mount can also be connected at the load place. Okay, and a CRO probe can be connected to this particular detector mount. Okay, and the readings can be measured using a CRO. Okay, so match termination as well as the detector mount are the two which can be used as a load, okay, either to close the whole bend setup circuitry or to take the readings or to measure the signal using a CRO probe which is connected to a CRO. Okay, so on the whole microwave bend setup has microwave devices as well as instruments. These microwave devices or the instruments are used for measuring the frequency, power, attenuation, and the voltage standing wave ratio of a wave inside the waveguide using a microwave bend setup or a microwave test setup. So this is the whole microwave test setup or a bend setup which we see. Okay, so if you see here, so this is an klystron power supply and this is a klystron mount. This is an isolator, this is a variable attenuator, this is a frequency meter connected to a slotted line. Okay, here you can see the slotted line section is connected to a particular meter. It can be a VSWR meter, it can also be connected to a CRO using a probe. Okay, the other end of the slotted line section is connected to a matched termination. If at all you want to take the reading from this particular load, okay, you can use a detector mount, and from the detector mount you can connect a CRO probe. That probe can goes to a VSWR meter or an CRO where we can take the readings of a waveform. So this is how a total microwave bend setup looks, and this is how a total microwave bend setup is used for, mainly for the measurement of frequency, power, attenuation, and the voltage standing wave ratios. Okay, all these parameters of a particular microwave frequencies can be taken into considerations in the laboratory aspects practically.